Hey YouTube, it's your girl, Lady L, aka Built with Beauty, aka Blenderella. And I'm gonna do a very quick review on the MAC 129 brush. It is a facial powder brush, and it also can be used as a blush brush. This was one of my very first MAC brushes. This was about 5 years ago. I got this brush in 2005, and it has stood the test of time. It is a very good brush for applying your powder, such as Fix Powder or the Mineralize Skin Finish or any kind of powder. I sometimes use my Invisible Setting powder for this, and it works just as good too. It is an all-around good brush that covers the face pretty well because it's real big, so it gets it in a quick amount of time. This brush retails for about $36.50. I know MAC is going up on their prices soon, so I don't know if it's changed, but it's like $36 for this brush. It can be purchased at any MAC standalone store, online, or any MAC counter for that fact. So yeah, if you're looking for a good brush, this is one of them. For powder, I really like it for powder, not so much for the blush, because it doesn't, I like to, you know, I mean, I guess, but I haven't used it for blush in a very long time. But yeah, and I only like to, one, you know, use my brushes for one purpose, not, you know, too many, especially with facial powders, because they can get mixed, whatever. Alright, so this brush, the only downfall to me is that it sheds right after the wash. Like, every time I wash it, I can't expect some shedding on that initial wash. That's my phone keep beeping, but yeah. You can't expect some shedding on the initial use after you wash it, but other than that, it's pretty good. So, that is my review of the MAC 129. Oh, it also comes in a short handle. This is the standard regular size, and it comes in a shorter size for those who like to carry their 129s or their face brushes with them. So yeah, there is a shorter version of this. And that concludes my review of the MAC 129. I hope you guys enjoyed, and stay tuned for more reviews